Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on linear algebra. Here we will be discussing about the final theorem on Jordan canonical form. So almost everything we have discussed in the last two videos, but let us finally summarize what we have done. So we are saying let T from V to V be a linear operator whose characteristic and minimal polynomials are like this. So what do you mean by these lines? It means that both the characteristic and the minimal polynomials, they are factored into linear factors. So it means that both the characteristic and linear polynomials are factored into both the characteristic and the minimal polynomial are factored into linear factors. Right, then T has a block diagonal matrix representation J in which each diagonal entry is a Jordan block. So you see, we are saying corresponding to lambda I, there will be many Jordan blocks. We are calling those Jordan blocks as Jij. This is corresponding to lambda I. Then J will vary from 1 to whatever is the number of the blocks. Okay. So it means that lambda 1 will have some number of Jordan blocks corresponding to lambda 1, and corresponding to lambda 2 we will have some number of Jordan blocks, and similarly corresponding to lambda we have some number of Jordan blocks. So these Jordan blocks Jij have following properties. First, there is at least one Jij of size Mi, right? This we already know from the last discussion, because this is the index of Ni, an index of Ti, Ni. This was the index of Ni, where Ti was Ni plus lambda I times I. So that is why we know that there is at least one block of size Mi for sure, and all other blocks will be of size less than is equal to Mi. So this is true. Then the sum of the sizes of Jij is Ni. Okay, so it means that corresponding to lambda 1, suppose there are 3 blocks, and suppose this is of size n1, this is of size n2, this is of size n3, then n1 we already have called, let us call it something else. Suppose this is of size p1, this is of size p2, this is of size p3, this is corresponding to lambda 1. Then obviously, because lambda 1 is an eigenvalue n1 times, so it means that in the final form, you can have only n1 times lambda 1 appearing. So p1 plus p2 plus p3 should be n1. So that is what we are saying here. The sum of the sizes of Jij is Ni. This is because Ni is algebraic multiplicity of the eigenvalue lambda I, and hence it should appear on the diagonal Ni times. Okay, all these things will help you when you will write the canonical form, Jordan canonical form. We will see in the next video the examples. And the last one is the number of Jij is equal to the geometric multiplicity of lambda I. How? We know that number of Jij is equal to nullity of Ni. Now what is Ni? Ni is your Ti minus lambda I. So this is equal to nullity of Ti minus lambda I. This is equal to dimension of the space. What are the elements here? Here are the elements. Nullity means we are talking about the kernel space. So we want T minus lambda I, V should be 0. That is, we want TV is equal to lambda I V. So whatever is the dimension of this space is the number of Jij's. Now what is the dimension of this space? This is the eigenspace of lambda I. So this is equal to the geometric multiplicity of lambda I. So it means that number of Jij's is equal to geometric multiplicity of lambda I. But we will not use this in the questions, because we have a better way of doing things. But still, this is the result. So it means that the number of Jij's of each possible size is determined by T. So everything is fully determined by T. So the moment you change T, everything will change. Right? So here, the only conclusion is, whenever there are linear factors, okay, whenever your minimal and characteristic polynomials are factored into linear polynomials, you have a Jordan canonical form. So let us summarize. Whenever the characteristic and minimal polynomial have minimal polynomials have linear factors or all the linear factors. It means that there is no factor which is not linear. Okay, polynomials are factored into linear factors. You can always write the Jordan canonical form. Now you see, if you are working on, so from here you can make a conclusion that if your field is field of complex numbers, you know that in field of complex number every polynomial can be factored into linear factors. For f is equal to c, you can always, you have Jordan canonical forms for all the possible matrices. Fine. So these are the, this is an important result. So it you see that you have a large category of matrices for which you can write the Jordan canonical form. Thank you.